My wife came with me yesterday to worship, and as I am off to do, I asked her, "So, honey, what did you think of the sermon?" To which she said, "It was all right." Confidence in one's life is one of the most important elements to a happy and fulfilling life, but it's not always that easy to maintain or to have. Vince Lombardi, the famous Packers coach, said, "Confidence is contagious, so is lack of confidence." An article in Psychology Today defines confidence as a belief in oneself, the conviction that one has the ability to meet life's challenges and to succeed, and the willingness to act accordingly. Now, this is not some fixed characteristic. It can be learned, it can be improved upon over time. In other words, it can change. If you work hard enough, if you develop a sense of accomplishment, or if you learn to grow from difficult situations, one can become more confident in life. Theodore Roosevelt, a former president of the United States in the early 1900s, seemed to be one of those kinds of people. Teddy, as he was known, was a person with overabundance of personality and confidence. But as a young child, he was often sick, and he worked incredibly hard to overcome his frailty. In his adult life, he was known for his tenacity and determination, fighting against business monopolies of the day, leading conservation efforts, and strengthening America's position in the world. After his death, a story circulated that on his first day in heaven, St. Peter, he said to St. Peter, "Your choir is weak, inexcusably weak. You need to reorganize it at once." So St. Peter assigned Roosevelt the task of reorganization of the heavenly choir. Roosevelt immediately responded, "I need 10,000 sopranos, 10,000 altos, 10,000 tenors." And St. Peter inquired, "But what about the basses?" "Oh," said the president, "I'll sing bass." That's confidence. Certainly he had confidence in himself. But when Paul is talking about confidence, it's more nuanced. Now, the word in Greek that he uses here is parousia, and it means to dare, to be bold, to be of good courage, to be cheerful or confident. Paul is speaking not so much about a personal confidence, but instead about a confident faith, a confidence and trust in God. Understanding who God is and what God does, and then trusting in his promises. As he says, we walk not by sight, but by faith. And God will fulfill his promises, even though we may not see it at first. Paul is saying Christians don't pattern our lives about what we see, in other words, what the world might give us, what it does or doesn't do. Instead, it's by faith. God provides us a greater spiritual reality, a greater way to see the world around us. God promises eternal life, blessing, rewards for those who follow, and we believe it, we trust it, we have confidence in it because God is true. And Christ gives us all the confidence that we could ever need. Suffering, trial, temptations, even death need not have any power over us. You can remain confident in God and in his plan for you. And what is that plan? That you and me, we will have a future that we can experience in this life right now, in all of its fullness in Christ. Joy, companionship, hope, grace, mercy, all of these are yours, given to you by Jesus. Of course, there will be times in our life when we will face anxiety. The pain of loss is real. But because we believe in Jesus, we have confidence to meet those challenges head on. I don't fear for myself. I don't fear for my family. I don't fear for the church. God's grace is working slowly, silently in the hearts of his people. When things seem dead, he gives life. When desperation sets in, he gives hope. When hatred rears its ugly head, love strengthens people of faith. You and I can be self-assured and confident because Christ is in us. He's given his life for us. And so Christ urges us on in our families, in our churches, in our communities, in our relationships with one another and with him. His sacrifice and death and glorious rising to new life, it changes everything. It changes how we see our world and our own lives. Because of Christ, you and I experience a new relationship with the divine. You become a new creation. You can know God and his goodness. And every relationship that you have, every moment that you experience, is touched by his grace and his love. Life is transformed. As Paul boldly proclaims, everything, everything has become new. And so we are confidently new. And confidence helps us, in the words of the old preacher, to face the worst, to believe the best, to do the most, and to leave the rest. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.